Hello, this is Good Morning, Mr. Magpie, and I'm Warren, your host. This is a tutorial of a song that is unreleased by Radiohead. It's also known as Morning Milord. I like Good Morning, Mr. Magpie. I don't know why. But I didn't even know about this song until I started doing these tutorials, and people started requesting this one, but I never got around to doing it. But now that there's the Kickstarter, I had to work hard for the money. This was one of the work hard for the money. This is one of the covers, okay, that was requested. And I had a lot of fun learning it, so hey, why not teach it, right? So the companion cover video is over there, I believe. And follow along. This one's tough, but it's a lot of fun, okay? And before I get started, Susan DiNicolo, Nathan Thomas Jung, Penn Zahao, you guys are awesome. Earn the shout out. And the backers that contribute financially, and all you lovely supporters, you subscribers, I couldn't do this without you. So let's get on with it. You're gonna do the strumming pattern where it's just down and up indiscriminately, okay? So there's no like discernible kind of syncopated pattern or anything like that, okay? And the way you kind of count this one, it's funny. It's in a 12-8, which is ridiculously hard to count, but so we counted in a 4 instead. So instead of going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, we actually say 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, okay? So that's kind of how I keep it straight. Now the ones and the threes are down strums and the twos and the fours are up strums. If you count all the triplets in the middle, you get exactly what I mean. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. But in the beginning, all the chords switch on down strums, okay? So if you're learning this, you're having trouble moving from chord to chord at the right time, just always remember it syncs up with your down strum. It feels like you're kind of progressing at the right time if you sync it up with the down strum, okay? And this helps you get a point of focus rhythmically. So the first chord is just a D, 0, 9th fret and 7th fret on the 3rd string, 0, 9, X, 7. XX. Now I've tuned my D string all the way down. I mean my E string all the way down to D. So the 6th string is matching the 4th string. Make sure you tune your guitar to drop D to play this song. I should have mentioned that in the beginning. But anyway, 0, 9, X, 7. 0, 7, X, 5. So it's the same shape. And then you move the same shape down again to 0, 5, X, 3. And then you go all the way up to 0, 10, X, 9, okay? And I'm using my ring finger and index finger for all these, and then I use my ring and my middle to play this one. So that's D, and then you go to kind of a D9, and then a G minor-ish over a D. And then you kind of go to a C over D without a C, so it's kind of implied. But anyway, that's what I call those chords. So, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So when I switch to that chord, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 3. New chord, 0, 0, 7, 7, X, X, X. That's 7 strings. 0, 0, 7, 7, X, X. Okay. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Short chord to long chord. To short chord to long chord. Long chord. Okay, and that's just a D with no 3rd. Okay, and then. Okay, so that's the intro and the outro. Now we're in the verse. You kind of just go straight into the verse and you ramp up your strum and make it sound real intense and fun, and you get to this A minor. Okay, 0, 1, X, 0, 2, 2, 1, 0, straightforward A minor chord. But you're gonna add this kind of funky thing to it, make it kind of like a cool riff. Your pinky is gonna hit 2 strings. Now that's on the 1st and the 2nd string, okay? And it's kind of awkward to just play that unless you kind of move your wrist a little bit. You kind of cock your wrist over. Is that cock? You cock your wrist over here and you add them like that. So it's kind of a little bit more comfortable. You don't lift any fingers by accident when you kind of move your hand and make it more comfortable for yourself, okay? So when do you play those extra notes on the third fret? You go 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 2, 3, and 1, 2, and okay, so now I go 2, 3, and then on the and, which is an up strum, okay, I lift the pinky. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and the second one is 1, 2, and okay? And so you kind of just practice with that. 2, 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4 to get it. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1. I just added a G major chord on 4, and that's the next thing you want to kind of add. And don't practice all of it at once if this is really difficult. Just break it in little chunks. 5x003x on B4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. The second measure always goes like that. Okay? Until you get to here, you don't have to do this to transition here. But it's 1x101x. And in the tutorial, in the cover, I'm actually playing two strings with my index, but that's not what Tom does. I just like it. So 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, x, and that's index finger, middle finger, and ring finger, like that. It's kind of hard to see what I'm doing here, but you know, you get the idea. And then you know you should. So you were on that chord for two measures, and one measure here, 4x4x3x. A lot of muting. Okay, one measure there, and then one measure here, which is like a D chord. So 0, 0, 4, 2, 3, 0. It's a D2 chord technically. So 1, 2. You know you should, but you don't. So if you guys notice, I've changed my strumming. And it's not the down, up, down, up, down, up anymore. What I'm doing is all the down strums are happening every three beats. And all the up strums are preceding each one of the down strums. It's kind of like this lazy feel, okay? It's called a shuffle. It also happens to work with 12-8 as well. So if you imagine the down strum happening on beat 1, up strum happens on beat 3, next down strum's on beat 4, 6, 7, 9, 10, 12, and this is too mathy, so I'm just gonna stop describing it. You just gotta feel it, okay? And then when you're feeling cool, you wanna add. And what I did there is an A minor, I just lifted up my index finger, okay? It's kind of a cool little variation Tom adds on the second verse. And then you go here. And this is, you've got some nerve. So that's 4x0230. Back to your D2 over just your D2. 0, 0, 4, 2, 3, 0. You've got some nerve. Sing it wrong. Come in here. Just like a little flash of that D over F sharp again. Okay, so that's the part where you got some nerve. Come in here. Okay, so I'm pretty much going to wrap this tutorial up right here, because part 2 is going to give me a little more, bit more time to explain how to play that part melodically, but it's going to be right here. If you want to figure that out with your ear and try not to look at my fingers, pretend you didn't see that, before you look at part 2, take it as a reward. I will love it if this video has more views than the second one. That tells me you guys actually, hopefully you didn't lose interest in the song, but that you took the challenge to try and use your ear. that's pretty much it, everybody. Thank you so much. Peace out. Part 2.